let's start.
Yeah, I'm just stalking somebody really fast. I'm trying to figure out what this girl is doing. I want to start the Q&A with some blood. I don't know if she just died.
You already said it, okay.
Alright, that's a dead person, Sergey. I'm a ruthless PvPer. Now we're gonna go.
Yes,
crack,
you are.
We're gonna go crack open this treasure chest right here and see what we won. And then we'll start the Q&A. This person probably not particularly happy about what I just did. Alright, what'd we win? Got a backpack, rangefinders, bandages, painkillers.
That's a lot of shit.
Yeah, they lost it. I spotted them, stalked them, and then just blew her head off. We'll just take everything. Prospect.
Yes, we are actually thought about making kind of seasons for a game, so like every year it's a new season, but it should be like a new map as well, so maybe we'll do it with California. Like, I mean, yes, we have this idea, but it's not like a plan or something.
Okay, let me see. Let me just grab this. And then we can have at it.
I am more PvP guy, so basically when the guys saying, PvE sucks, like, guys, I feel you. I'm in the same boat. This guy right there, he's like PvP guy, he have good time.
Yeah,
I am pretty miserable.
We basically just killed you in game, Sergey. You were just that person sitting there looting and killing zombies, and I was just like, head gone.
Stenex 45 and Stenex 16 C mags spawned again. Actually, C mags are being spawned. I think it's super really rare. But that's about it. And I'm not sure even if you can buy right now 45 and 60. I didn't sell them in the store.
You can actually look.
Yeah, can you check? Because I think they are not in the store. No. There is 10x 60. Yeah, 60. At least 60 you can buy. Yeah, but the idea is like, yeah, you have your basic magazine for 30 bullets, and then you have 10x C mag, which is awesome, but really it's more like cosmetic. Why you can't buy 10x 30 from marketplace? Because it's so easy to find it in the game, so I don't know at all. Sniper vibe or no? Actually, right now it's about 55% saying no, 45% saying yes. So obviously, to even consider that, we need to have like what, like 70% saying yes, at least. So like, yeah, I really don't think it's gonna happen now, but who knows. It's actually kind of curse. That's a good question about that the game feel that there is nothing to do there because it's sandbox, and that's kind of curse of sandbox games, that it's really hard for you to build sandbox game that will be appealing to different players. And for us it's like PvP versus PvE, and actually make game to be excited for everyone. Like, I mean, let's take GTA for example. GTA kind of survives on single player story, and if you are not playing GTA a single player story, and like I am lazy guy, I'm just going around in GTA and like steal cars and do shit like that. Like, yeah, it's getting actually bored after some time, and GTA is like fucking awesome game developed for like 6 years by 100 million people team. So basically any sandbox game to make it long-term, long-lasting experience is a bitch. It's hard to do. We are trying. At the same time, we're not gods and probably not the guys who have solution to everything. So we are trying different things, and we'll see that. Remove G-seeds for noobs. When Colorado V2 and California... Colorado V2 is the final test. California, as I said before, it's probably end of the year, so that's where you should expect it. Get rid of premium servers. Why? I mean, premium servers are good. They're good for a game. They're good for guys who play in them. And let me explain how they're good for a game. Once again, goes back to simple fact that every month we spend money on paying for servers, paying for development team, paying for guys around us who are supporting you guys, and finding bugs, fixing bugs, and doing shit like that. That costs money. So selling game for $15 just doesn't cover that for that long. So yes, we have to find, unfortunately, we have to find the ways to make money, kind of have recurring revenues, and premium servers and premium account is basically like kind of idea of same as ideas when you play in WoW, you're paying for subscription. It's basically the same thing. I mean, you don't need to use that, to be honest. Even though premium servers have good, better loot, that's obviously what you get for $10 a month. But outside that, still, okay, those guys are playing on those servers. They probably sometimes go back to normal servers, got killed, and you get all of their loot. This game, in the state as is, will not going to be on consoles. So
I think we'd play terrible on consoles too.
Oh, I don't think necessarily. Why? I mean, GTA plays good. GTA is a big map.
Is so it like nearly as open world though? Like, I mean,
yeah, it's completely open world. You can do whatever you want. It's like GTA is a fucking cool game. So it's a good sandbox game. But I mean, it can be played. But yeah, it's probably not going to happen just because of the costs involved and everything, just amount of work. When Punkbuster was fixed, because hit by blah blah blah. That's more a question to Punkbuster than to us. Will you get banned by IP? Okay, so bans by IP, bans by hardware ID. Why it's a bad idea? And to be honest, I personally want to do that, but unless we will make our game completely free to play, we can't really do ban by hardware ID. Here's why. Let's say you bought the game, you got in the game, you cheated, you got banned, and your hardware ID was detected, and you get banned forever. Now, since game itself and the selling of the serial keys are two different things, guys who are sell serial keys, and that's in this this case company, it's external company called Exola. No, I actually don't eat cheetahs. So that's external company Exola. They take your money and they sell you serial key, which then you can use in our game. So think of that Exola actually works for us, same way as Steam or any game store or any distributor. They are distributing our game, essentially taking money, your money, dealing the four of your billing questions and all that stuff. We provide you game. Now, you bought new key and Exola sold you key, and you come to the game and you got banned instantly and you haven't even done anything. Maybe you are want to play the judo. It doesn't matter. So from our perspective, we can do that. We can do whatever we want. We can ban by hardware ID. But then Exola, those guys can go back to them and say, what the fuck? Where is my money? Like, I paid for a product and I can't use this product. So that opens like basically cans of worms, and they have to refund money. So that will create more problems, more harm to us than actually any good. And by IP, IPs are shared, IPs are reused. So lots of internet service providers, especially residential ones, they basically can assign you IP, and in 1 week they give you new IP, and probably your IP will be used by some other guy, maybe your neighbor or somebody like 1 mile away. And it will be sucks if you got banned because you cheated, and this new guy like starts in playing and like, ah, you got banned for no reason. That sucks. Yes, we may have some shots of something in Vegas. yes, we discussed, we are not going to make an option for turn off shadows. I think that's essential for a game, unfortunately. So if your guy bought GC and didn't got GC, he needs to go to Exola. Exola support is awesome. They have a toll-free phone number, I think, in all countries. They do speak in your native language, whatever it is, most likely. So it's much you just go to them and says, okay, guys, I spent money, I didn't got GC, what the fuck? They will solve that. They have all tools to do that. Cuke Vegas equals strip clubs. Yeah, Cuke, I'm not sure if he'll go there, but we'll see. Why we are not removing safe zone? Why we should remove safe zone? I mean, that's kind of part of the gameplay, so it's an interesting question. We're not doing bans by IP, so I doubt if you got banned by IP, you actually got banned. You can't be banned by IP, you got banned for something. Why so many bans applied wrongfully and why it fix takes so long? As we actually showed you guys, there is really small percentage of ban that been applied wrongfully, and most of the time we solve the thing, we try to solve it in less than a month. Territorial control for PvP, that's a fucking good question. We really want to do that. We really kind of discussed larger metagame for WorZ, and okay, I said WorZ, right? Infestation. for our game. so that's something we are discussing as like larger meta gameplay. Can you expect our game on 7 new consoles coming in 2014 on Steam consoles? To be honest, guys, we are not. At least, okay, I'm not. Maybe other guys at the office, they do that, but I'm not really following all this thing happening around Steam and SteamOS and Steam machines and stuff like that. So I can say that if those consoles are PCs running Windows, then obviously you can run any of our games. I actually, about shaving my head, I once a year I do really, 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 really short Dolma's bald haircut. So hopefully at some point in the future you will see that and you will save yourself $50. It'll be for free. Oh, okay, so once again, for guys who missed Colorado V2, we're almost there. Map is running fine. Things we are checking right now are spawns. Since we have new weapon spawn system, that's another stuff. So basically, it takes longer than we expected, but once again, map is there, map is running fine, spawns, once we fix that, then fine. Okay, third person ruins competitive FPS feeling. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, so let me talk about that because that's a good topic for discussion, and we actually have, not we, but okay, it's not us at all, but the studio who I am personally involved in financing what they are doing, they are basically working on the game that have option of either third person or first person, and there is a huge discussion went like yesterday, should the game be only first person because it's more competitive, or should be third person left because it's actually doesn't change anything. So idea is that if you're playing competitive game that gives you option to switch between those two, and if it's really, really competitive sport, then yes, it's probably give you unfair advantage. That's true. And at the same time, I don't think that Infestation is actually that competitive esport type of the game where you do everything you do to climb leaderboards and be best in the country or something like that. So what do you think actually about it? You are PvP-er, so for PvE, third person is good. For PvP, so
I just think it creates really unfair situations where I kill people that they never even had a chance because of third person. What I'll do is I'll do what I call a bait move, where I pretend that I'm much worse than I am. And I'll run and turn my back to, say, you've spotted me. And I will run through a doorway and deliberately not look at you so that you don't think I've spotted you. I'll run through the doorway, and then I'll stand on that doorway with third person. And lo and behold, they'll come over, curious cat, walk right over, and I'll just count down on stream. He's dead in 3, 2, just peek out, just boom, head's gone. And he never saw me. He never got to know that I knew he was still there, whereas if... It was the difference is if I was in first person, I'd have to peek to see if he's crossing the street, yeah. And then he would be alerted that I knew he was there. Instead, he never knew that I knew he was there, and because of third person, I just killed him instantly. So as far as competitive, third person really kills competitive stuff.
But is the game is actually competitive?
I don't think it's a very competitive game. I think it's more about fun and looking for items and killing other players, and you know that sandbox, like you can kind of do anything. You're a vigilante.
So Cuke, don't remove third person view and crosshair. Cuke, don't remove that.
I don't know, guys.
When GC revives going to be set at reasonable price? I think the price reasonable, but that's me. I can't say for all the players. Here's what we do, guys. Actually, we'll do experiment, and we did a lot of those in last month, but we'll do experiment for you. We will lower GC revive price for this weekend starting today once we finish this stream, actually, and we'll see what will happen? Are more people will be using them or not? And if not, then the price before was fair, right? If more people will start using them, then okay, that's perfect. We'll keep it as low as we set it today. So, by the way, one interesting thing I want to talk to you about, and that's I'm talking to community. So, and be welcome to go and discuss that on forums, that interesting topic. So, we, in last month, we did several things. We added tons of new loot, and tons of loot, like loot is spawning much better than a few months before. We also remove almost all GC items and made almost everything except three or four items purchasable with game dollars.
Yeah, steam eggs and the drums.
And that's it. Yeah, basically.
Hammer. I don't know why hammer.
After that, and we also kind of cut down and cracked down on GC traders. And that lowered actually number of cheats in the game right now, which is a good idea. But those changes as well, obviously, like removing GC items from the store affected our profits negatively, right? We were making less money out of the game. But to be honest, I personally think that in long term, if it's better for community, it's better for everybody. So that was a good move. But once we did it, we found that during the next week after we done that, we done those two steps, we actually start seeing less people playing the game than before, which was weird for us. Like from our standpoint, that was only one explanation to that, that people who left and who stopped playing been people who've been exploiting the game, using cheats, and been basically participating in GC trade and basically using game to make money. And we kind of killed their business, make it much more tougher to do, much harder to do, so they left the game. We still don't know if it's case or not, but that's interesting stuff. We make a game better for community. Less people started playing the game. Funny, interesting. It's not like a deal breaker. It's not like we lost half of the users or anything like that. But that's was not slightly noticeable. So that's by the way, guys. How it's kind of interesting thing how business side of the game development works. Normally, if it happened 6 months ago, we'd said, what the fuck? And we'd return GC items, we lowered loot back where it was, and we basically started like, okay, yeah, we did something wrong, we need to revert that. Now we're not doing that, we actually trust in our community to figure out what they are doing, and we feel that all of those changes were good for the game. Do you want to make more loot on the premium servers? Probably not, but once again, we are monitoring that. When you will stop lying and tell the truth? I am telling the truth all the time. Art is sleeping. Yeah, he is sleeping. He's checking his phone right now.
Sent an email. Since my computer's tied up.
Yeah, there will be no patch today. That's guys. That's Friday. It's a bad idea to make patches on Friday.
No support over the weekend or less.
Yeah,
support.
Private. It's about same support, but then development guys are on weekend. So. Private premium servers most likely not gonna happen. I'm just straightforward, probably not gonna happen. Why you can't find any hammers? No idea. Why pole snipers? Yes, as we said, like most of the guys say no, It's basically 50-50 right now for the community guys saying that, and I don't feel that we can actually wipe it based on like only half of the votes from the community, unfortunately.
Yeah, we just wanted to see what people would say.
Yeah, it's basically the whole idea for survey was like, okay guys, you are playing the game, tell us what you think. Servers are Brazil is in a progress, but as I explained last time, servers in Brazil cost about 3 times more than servers in the US or in Europe for that matter, and unfortunately, even though we have huge population of Brazilian players, probably one of the largest, they are not one of the largest in terms of revenues, so we should be careful about that. Can you sell a key to the server? I'm not sure what does it mean, but...
He means like for a private server so he can give it to his friends and have like, you know, multiple passwords for a server. So he can have public access to like, say, I tell Cha, hey, the password's derp. But he wants to be able to change the password that's like his public password. So his friends can always get in no matter what. Basically like a whitelist for the server. People can join it regardless of password.
Yes, we are actually discussed that. As I said, we really want to add way more options to control private servers. Right now, it's pretty shitty in my opinion. I personally want to do more on my server. Yes, I want to have whitelist. I want to have ban list too, for that matter. And I want to have set some restrictions on my servers. Who can join, who can't. And even I want to say only premium players or veteran players can join that. Actually, for a veteran, I can do that right now by setting the number of hours. What happened to California? We are in California right now, as far as I see it around me. California is still there, so there is no tsunami or anything. If you are talking about the map, it's in development, and I think Roman. AKA Russian Caliber showed some screenshots like a day ago or something. So it's going on, but as I said several times, probably end of the year. No, California. Actually, right now, all of our, 100% of our team efforts are on California. So, there will be more stuff in the game like animals hunting, swimming, something like that. Campfires, maybe. Tents? No, I don't think we will have tents. I mean, to be honest...
Lockbox is already kind of a tent.
Yeah, if you think about tent as a tent, think about it as barricades, right? We can make a tent barricade and put it in the world. Is it worth it or not? Don't know. Did infestation programmers learn through college? No, they all like bumps who doesn't know anything how to create games or anything. So that's why game isn't stated as I don't think they can even read or write or anything. So I think they are just guys who are sitting in their offices, cubicles, and type something gibberish. And then there is some chance if they do it all the day long, they get some code that it's actually can be compiled and at some point it works. So yeah, we company like that, we are trying to do that. We actually just ordered, we spent probably like 70% of our profits, or we ordered 10,000 monkeys, and we're expecting them to be delivered to us somewhere in December. Once they are, we are renting a huge new office with lots of computers, so probably you will see much more features coming at that time. Monkeys will need like probably a month or two to acclimatize and like start typing, but after that, yeah, we will have cool shit coming out. Helicopters, planes, no. Cars, yes. Cars will be there. Vodka, yes, vodka. We actually thought about using monkeys for support as well, but unfortunately, we tried, we did some tests, and people just don't understand what they are saying, so it's kind of hard. First person only servers. Maybe. Actually, maybe. Have you thought about turrets like portable sentries? We actually did thought about that. I think it was like 6 months ago and it didn't went anywhere. So that, that's lame answer, I know that, but yeah, we thought about that. I don't think it's went anywhere. What about people could trade sniper in return for GC? To get some of them off the game, HP will give GC for snipers. No, we are actually, okay, so we don't like and don't allow GC trading. At the same time, we think about that this way. You guys are inventive type. So we think that our goal and our role as designers of the game to make sure that you won't be able to do that. But if you will find some weird way to trade using GC, then only thing we will do, we'll actually try to close this loophole. We think that trading should be between players and for items only. I think it should be within game, not for not to enrich other, one person or another. Why you have deleted 50 people servers? it just wasn't kind of, there wasn't much of the reason why we should keep them going. Full gamepad support. I think there is some gamepad support right now, but I don't think we will add a full game gamepad support at all. Will the game have Steam trade card? We actually talking with Steam. And we are discussing what we can use from the basically huge bag of cool Steam stuff they have, including Workshop and stuff like that, and WarZ/Infestation. But so far, there is no any definitive plans. Did I ever live in Russia? Yes, I actually was born in Russia. I lived there for almost all of my life in Moscow. New loot system and V2. Okay, so two kind of things to discuss there. First of all, how we place loot. We kind of started doing that with V1, but in V1 we developed like huge overhaul of the map. We've been unable to do what we want to do. But idea is that when you go into someplace, you should be able to find all the items that you naturally can find in this place. So for example, if you go into some farmhouse, you need to be able, you should expect that you will find obviously water there, you will find food there, you will find some basic medication, and you will find some of the weapons, including guns. You probably most likely won't find like M4 fully automatic or M16 there, but you will find shotguns, you will find 22 calibers, you will find some handguns and stuff like that. In the same time, if you go into the city and you go into places there, then most likely you won't find shotguns, but you will find more of handguns there. So that's kind of like more logical loot distribution. And the second part is redesigned weapon spawns for rare and cool and like advanced weapons. We have more tighter control over where they spawn and how they spawn. So that alone will allow us to kind of basically make rare guns, including snipers, are really rare and worth something. Without going to play to stuff like, okay, yeah, we're not spawning some weapon at all or spawning like once a year. Why remove item boxes in Boulder? As I said, when we did changed spawns, we changed actual logic what is being spawned, but we didn't change location and settings for each spawn point in the game. So that's why you are getting like that item box, and you knew that in the past there was like only cool shit in there. Now it's you can find like other items that you normally can find in this location. That's great situation where it's item box, you go in there and instead of like nice sniper rifle or something in there, you find like chem light. That sucks. Free map editor is not gonna happen. It's just like nature of the game. It's a server controlled game, so that's why. Mission system. Okay, so mission systems is like that. You will have list of missions, and this list kind of be sliding, so every few days you will be getting new set of available missions which you can accept to do, and you can accept only a limited number of missions at the same time. So basically you can't have more than, let's say, 3 active missions going on at the same time. Once you complete mission, you will get reward, and to complete mission you basically need to once again do whatever mission says, mission goal. For example, you need to deliver some item or to some place, or you need to go somewhere and retrieve some data from computer and then return to the guy who gave you mission. So that's how missions will work. Missions will be way to get experience, get in-game currency, and get some rare items.
Huh? Okay. Oh, whoops.
Is it possible to do little tour of California maps? I think that's what we will do. It's kind of preview of the California map by during our event in Vegas. I think that's, I don't think the map will be at the state where I can actually show it to the public before that. Why you don't expand our support team, for example, like League of Legends, the Tribunal? Okay, so that's two questions, or maybe I just don't understand. So why we don't expand support team? People count, like how many people are playing there? Are actually supporting you guys? We thinking about that. It all depends on how much money we are making. So basically, how much money we have to pay to those guys? If we have same amount of money as League of Legends, yeah, we will have probably like 2,000 people supporting you. Next, Tribunal. We actually thought about making the system that allows players to judge other players and ban them actually. We are still, this system is still in design. It's a long process because that's something that can be easily exploited by people, and it's not something that can be done like in 2 months. I think for Tribunal in League of Legends it took more than 2 years in development or something like that. How rare I think assault rifles, military weapons should be. Okay, that's in my opinion. I actually discussed that. I've been talking to Russian Caliber other night, and we've been talking about PvE aspect of the game, survival aspect of the game, and like I, he and me been saying, okay, yeah, if you want to make it more like PvE and survival, we need to make sure that nobody can find almost any weapons at all, as well as food, water, and everything is super scarce, and you basically spend 99% of your time trying to find those
just
things.
Trying to live.
Yeah, just trying to loot, and you just don't have ammo to shoot other players. But that will, I think, in my opinion, it will kill PvP aspect at all, like completely. It will kill the game. It will be different game. It will be survival game, right? But is it gonna be fun game for current player base? I don't think so. What's about more character customizations? Maybe. There is actually a huge problem with how we design art, because let's be honest, it's basically you buying character, you're getting some skins for free, and there is not much of the like deep customization for a character. You can change like his skin tone, you can add tattoos, you can add like even boots and stuff like that. Is it something we can change? Yes, by making a new game. What we are doing for security, and if we've been hacked. Okay, so some information about that. We actually been hacked just once, but and it was like in late 2012. The guy who, or guys who hacked us, they got access to some of our external stuff, and they installed backdoor on our forums. So first time it was actually legitimate hack. The second time where the guys bring down servers, forums, and claim they have access to everything. They actually just had access to forums only, and they had access to some old data from back 2012. Since that time, and that was like humbling experience for us. We've been careless in a number of spots, but yeah. So we basically revamped our security completely. We changed how servers works, we changed a lot of things, and I think the system is much more secure right now. At the same time, okay, we are a relatively small company. companies like World of Tanks, Electronic Arts, Activision, Ubisoft, Sony, Riot Games, they all got hacked and their data got stolen. Unfortunately, that sucks. It's happened. Only thing we can do, we are working to minimize chance of that happening in the future, and we are making sure that even if it happens, it doesn't affect much of our player base. No, you won't be able to host your own game server on your own machine. Reason for that is
tampering.
Yeah, it's basically you. If you do that, you have full control of what's going on in the game, and you can. You don't even need cheats anymore. You can create cheats on server, and that's basically kills the whole game. So, unfortunately, no, you won't be able to do that. Just good example of what can happen if check. Okay, no, that's. I want to name this game until they suck, but okay. There is example of another survival game that allows you to do that. Oh, yes, better you have full control over cheats, but Hammerpoint is doing relatively good job at controlling the cheats. Not Hammerpoint actually, but OP Production, I should say. Hammerpoint is just a developer. Man,
this is something that's been coming up a lot. The sniperless servers. What do you think about that? That's one of the solutions that we've been discussing in the sniper thread.
I think it's not a solution, to be honest, but I think it's just one of the things that, like, if you rent your own server, that should be some options. Like, as I said, from my standpoint, I should be saying, okay, I allow melee weapons, handguns, assault rifles, shotguns, SMGs, and snipers, and that's literally checkboxes, and I can choose whatever I want. So like, we need more configuration options for server, that's it. And then if you want to create sniperless, power to you.
So there's your answer, guys. It's probably going to be on privates. I don't think it'll be public sniperless servers.
Actually.
I mean, unless... So I mean, that's something that's being discussed.
No, it wasn't been discussed, but we can try to do that on public test and see how people are going.
Well, that's what I want to do for the V2 test. Well, I mean, we're discussing some other ways.
If we add weapon degradation, snipers won't die out. A reason for that, we are not going to add degradation to items that sits on your GI. Only if
it degrades on use.
Yeah, it degrades on use. So. We are not going to have separated GI for California or for any other map. Like, whatever is it solution or not, but it's just how the game is designed, it's how it's coded. It will require tremendous amount of efforts for us to do that. It's technically possible, but it basically means we'll have to kill huge list of other features and stop doing basically supporting the game and doing just that feature. I don't think that's makes sense. It will happen.
Yeah, like this right here. Few public CQC servers. So basically everything goes except snipers, just like five of them. Is that something we could do? Just if, you know, since we're so 50-50 on the sniper wipe?
It's not super easy to do so, unfortunately. All right,
there you have it, Mad Max. Mad Max is super active on the forums, has like 4,000 posts, and figured try and get his question answered by... There you have it, Mad Max.
It's you do?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm not in the loop. Hugh said they have solution for that.
Mad Max actually helped with the solution.
Cool, so Mad Max helped the solution. You know that I'm out of the loop, I am schmo.
No, but the question was, are we going to have like five public servers where
that's,
we will do that? Because Sergey answered it about private servers.
Yeah, private servers is what we've talked about so far.
Okay, but yeah, but still not.
Not public? Okay, yeah.
Public
not
needs
public.
To be discussed with the team.
Okay, yeah, so same, yeah, we've already had that.
Lowering recoil by mouse is bannable? No, if you are actually using your mouse and you move your mouse to compensate for recoil, that's legitimate play. Why we should ban you? Okay, so for people who saying I got banned while blah blah blah, I'm not did anything, I made a ticket but it haven't been read for weeks now. Okay, so how, here's inside story, and here's a disclaimer right now. I am sitting there as executive producer of the game and the guy from, let's say, Hammerpoint or Arctis. I'm not sitting there and talking as executive or official representative of IP production, who is a publisher and who is handling all the bands, all support tickets and all that stuff. But from what I understand, that's how it works. When you got banned and you submitted ticket, the minute you submitted the ticket, it's basically system automatically checked why you've been banned. And there is a score point there, something blah, something stuff like that. I don't really like, not the best person to talk about how like this whole ban system works, to be honest. But it basically checks if there is possibility that this ban was unfair. If it finds it is, then your ticket getting prioritized and probably will be looked, not probably, but it will be looked at in short period of time, like week or two, by real person, and then decision will be made if ban was right or not. But if you submitted ticket, system checked it automatically and found that you've been banned for shooting three guys in a 5 seconds from 500 meters using your handgun, then no, dude, you will not be, your ticket will just go into the limbo. It will never be reviewed by a person, you will never be unbanned.
That's what a lot of the tickets are. I mean, that one day where I was checking some bans for people, 99% of people were just like, you really want me to look at this? Like, this is a waste.
Yeah.
Like, they're just so blatantly cheating. You'll never get a response if you
like you did it for more tickets than I am. I actually like long time ago went on forums, and when people been saying I've been banned, I was like, I basically went look why they've been banned, and I basically posted like, hey dude, you've been banned for that and that, and I just posted it on forums. So that was funny. Like, not a single guy had like we had any doubt why he was banned. Especially was funnier than the guys been using like some crazy cheats, like they teleported across the map. I got banned. Oh, okay. Nice. What do you think about playing only in first person? Yeah, we just discussed that. It's probably something we should do as an option for private servers. I discovered a glitch in a clear water. Am banned if I enter that. Don't enter that. Like, if you found the glitch, ideally just send it to our support and says, okay guys, that's a bug, please.
And yeah, if you do find a bug like that, if you can either make a video, take a screenshot, and then just send it to me.
Yeah,
yeah,
so
that's your
option. So hacked accounts, that's something I actually wanted to talk about. Guys, when your account got hacked, and I mean legitimately hacked by somebody who stole your password or something, that sucks. That sucks balls. Like, my account at Origin been hacked twice. And I think Origin had some exploit or something, so like lots of people lost their account. But at least the Origin, I was able to call EA, and I have friends there. Actually, I went through friends, and they basically just reset my email to whatever it was before, so I was able to restore my account. My email wasn't hacked, it was just a password for Origin. So, unfortunately, that shit happens. And you can go to some phishing websites, somebody, most of the time it's social engineering, so somebody somehow gets your password and do that. Not always, but sometimes somebody hacks your email and then they just reset password. So, couple things. Use strong passwords, number one. Number two, use different password for your email and your Infestation or any other game's account. So for example, hypothetically, you are playing Infestation, you are playing, what game was recently hacked?
I don't know, it was recently hacked. I mean, I literally spend all my time playing this game.
Okay, League of Legends maybe.
Was it an FPS?
Dota, like, I mean, let's say you are used the same password on Infestation and the other game that got hacked. And that password was brute forced. And let me be straightforward. If your password is 12345, it will be brute forced by any decent computer NVIDIA video card in less than like 30 minutes. It's super easy process. Even if it's super hashed, salted and all that. So it's only way to make sure it takes time if you use like password exclamation mark 35. And it's like 12 characters long. So use strong password. It sucks, by the way. I can't remember them all. I have like probably like 10 passwords, and I have them on my iPhone on the notes. so I actually go in there and type when I need to log into something, but that's what you have to do. Unfortunately, lots of the time when your account got hacked, we can't do much. We can restore your password, we can reset your email, stuff like that, but if your items are gone, sometimes we can't legitimately verify if it was because you got hacked or it was just you did that, just gave your items away to somebody. How can ISS compete the Frost and DayZ? Do you think it's competing well? Okay, so I don't think we are competitors, the Frost. I think Rust is a completely different game. I enjoyed Gary's mod a lot. I played it a lot back in the days, and I played Rust, and I think Rust is a different game. I think ISS right now, it's a really PvP centered survival game. Rust is more like Warcrafty build. DayZ and ISS, they are different games. It's like we probably like our biggest fuck up back in the days when we launched WarZ was number one to name the game WarZ. I hated this name, by the way, but publishing guys decided it's a good idea. Oops, nerd. I from my standpoint we weren't really clear why WarZ, DayZ, where it stands, and DayZ influenced us a lot, as well as like John Romero's movies, as well as bunch of other games. Like, for God's sake, we literally copied design from Crysis for customizations of weapons because it's a good design, and like it's inspired us. That was kind of like our mistake that we didn't explain it really well, but But I think right now, when you are playing the game, you are seeing that DayZ experience and Infestation experience are different. I think the release of Standalone, whenever it will happen, I don't know when it's going to happen, but when it will happen, I think you will see even more differences. So how it will compete with them or stand against those games, guys, we are... Q have, I think, S4 or A4 Audi, but okay, going back to competition, yeah. I think in our first year of operations, we made so much mistakes, and we learned so much, and we advanced our backend system, server system so much, so all of the new guys, they will have to go through the same... same process. Like, it's like, okay, yeah, so do you expect that like any new game will be free of bugs and free of problems, and especially like issues with balancing and everything? No, I don't think so. I think they will have exactly same mistakes, exactly same problems. It will take 6 months for each of those new games to actually progress to the state where Infestation is in right now. I mean, not in terms of gameplay, but in terms of stability and bugs and all that. So, I mean, we'll see. I don't think that DayZ is same game appealing to same audience. I think it's a different audience. And if Jordan are John saying DayZ developers are idiots, they are not. I have a huge respect for Dean Hall for what he's done. I think he have huge challenge in front of him, basically going from mod where he's not responsible for bugs, for cheats or anything, to full feature game where he have to basically be front of the project like I was for Warzy, and basically saying, okay, guys, we are working on that, we are working on fixing this, but I think a huge respect for a guy, and I think they are not idiots. They are good guys, they are making awesome game, hopefully it will be out soon, so... our game won't be on life, because I think on life is dead. It's true.
It's too soon.
No, 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 actually, I played on life, I played Gaikai a lot, and it's working fine. Like, we actually did same solution as Gaikai did for Sony, we did for a company called GameStreamer. We basically developed the whole suite and whole thing for streaming games, so we can implement that ourselves, if you want to. But the thing is, it's not there yet. It's not there yet. It's there. It's here as technology. Technology is awesome. It's working. For at least for casual players, not casual, mid-core players, right? But business-wise, like how you make viable business out of that, I think that's not there yet. For streaming, I think it's coming in next 5 to 10 years. Speak about strongholds and the vehicles. Vehicles, you will find vehicles in the world. You'll get into vehicle. You don't have to pay money to actually buy vehicle. You don't need to do that. You just find vehicle, you get in vehicle, you put the gas in, and maybe you repair it, you drive.
No nightmares.
Yeah, stuff like that. For strongholds, they are coming. Guys are working on them right now. You will be able to build your own base on Stronghold and upgrade it. That's about it. And if you decide that you want to actually make your own private games, if you're kind of, when you set the rules, that will be a way for Strongholds to go. Stronghold servers, at least at first, I'm not sure if it ever will not have zombies. It will be smaller map, specially designed for to be your safe haven or your personal hell, and whatever you will be doing that. So if you want to play counter-strike on your stronghold map, you will be able to do that. Actually, this guy right there is like saying, we should make strongholds maps so they like more like Call of Duty counter-strike maps. And like, hey guys, that's for PvP players. I think it would be great for...
We're going to have a forum post of what you guys want to see in Strongholds and what you're expecting of Stronghold maps, because basically I know right now streamers have kind of defined Strongholds as taking a location like the mini market and then putting up barricades and then saying, come and kill us. So I'm wondering, is that what you're looking for in Stronghold maps right now on top of, you know, the building mechanics? So we're going to have a big discussion thread, just like the whole sniper discussion thread, and I want to just get all you guys' feedback so that we can properly make sure that, you know, maybe we're going to have, you know, a few maps for it, and maybe one stronghold map will be a different type of stronghold than another one, so it's not just you're, you know, trapped in an area just waiting for people to attack. You know, maybe we can add some more complex, cool things to it than just that.
Yeah. Okay, so why you're not making... So first of all, guys, there'll be no... There is no plans right now for any sniper spawns. Like, just so we're clear, so you're not gonna lose your snipers right now. Like, forget about that. We ask people 50-50.
It's 50-50, so.
Yeah. So it's not gonna happen anytime soon. Now, Daisy weapons are realistic, ours are, and infestations are not. I mean, both Daisy and infestations are games. And as a games, we made decisions what we want to have from the game. I think what we have is more fun and more game. That's it. I don't like Arma. like, it's not our intent to make super hardcore simulation for loading gun and running with your head swing and stuff. We're not making Arma game. That's it. It's like, if you like Arma, play Arma. The infestation is not the Arma. When can we expect what we can expect on the trip to Vegas? We are going to show you lots of new cool features. You will basically meet the team and talk to the team. We will have some fun dinner, nightclub, if anybody wants that. So we will have some fun and discuss the game. Our goal, so here's our goal for that. We want to show you new features. And those new features, after we show them in Vegas, will be coming into the game literally next week. We also want to kind of poke the brains of streaming guys and our community guys, players from and forum guys, what they are expecting from the game in our second year of existence, and so we can plan what we are doing. Infestation emulators. There is no such thing as infestation emulators. There is very old version of stolen source code from infestation from November 2012, and those guys are using that. And yes, we are using some legal measures, and I just don't want to go into that and discuss that, because lots of them are done not by us, not by our lawyers, but by local law enforcement agencies in the countries where those guys reside and host. So I think it's not anymore like civil lawsuits or anything. It's full-fledged criminal charges and stuff like that. So that's I think up to law enforcement to deal with that. I don't think, I think it's obviously harm for us. It's did a lot of damage. At the same time, I think that I don't believe that anybody can actually use the code and everything, and especially assets, to make something that really competes in the fast in terms of like quality and in terms of widespread and can basically take in a large portion of our audience in the long run. So premiums for 30 days and for 15 for pioneers for legendary. We gave it at some point and it's basically expired. So if you, let's say we did it like a month ago and you just now came in, so that's. War Z is such a copy of War Inc. No, it's not. Okay, so let me go over this whole process. Because that's probably be boring text, boring wall of text in my conscience. So there is still a company called Online Warmongers, which I financed, and then I sold half of the company to a French company called Cybergun. So Online Warmongers been developing and operating and publishing the game called War Inc. That's a shooter. When we decided to make War Z, it was really obvious from our perspective that we want to save time. For example, we have weapons in War Inc. which are good. So to save time, we basically went to War Inc. Online Warmonger shareholders and says, guys, we want to buy assets from you. We want to buy graphics, art, models, and stuff like that. We don't need source code because we actually, our company owns the source code, not them, not the War Z, too. So we bought art assets. We saved ourselves time by that. That's why by now I think outside weapons, and couple characters. 90% of models and in War Z are unique and made from scratch, especially for terrains, grass, trees, and stuff like that in most of the buildings. So we actually thinking about you being able to buy premium for different duration and actually stack it so you can have like 90 days left of premium. So yes, we are thinking about that. That's kind of so if HP or any other divisions of HP like OP and Artis are looking. Okay, so there are no other divisions of HP. HP is actually a division of Artis. OP Production is a separate company and its sole purpose of existence is operate, publish, and own IP for Infestation. So my company, Artis Entertainment, is a shareholder in OP Production. So we have stake in that company. I am sitting on the board of IP Production, yet I can't influence everything that IP Production does with games. So if, for example, other shareholders of IP Production tomorrow will say, guys, let's make Infestation, sell weapons and sell everything for GC, only thing I will be able to do against that, he says, guys, we are quitting, we are not developing game anymore. Because Hammerpoint is contracted, hired by OP Production and paid some amount of money every month to continue development of the game. Other than that, we don't have actually influence on the operations of Infestation, unfortunately. Going back to your question, Hammerpoint right now is not working on any other games. At the same time, Arctus have investment in other teams and other companies that are making their own games right now. So it's so that's kind of where we stay right now. So yes, I am involved in other projects financially. I'm not executive producer, I'm not designer or stuff like that, but I am involved in them. Hammerpoint is not doing that. Hammerpoint actually had one another game in development, and it's been put on hold. It's been basically canceled and sold off to other team because we felt that Hammerpoint should concentrate on Infestation development. Did you work on big rigs of racing, Sergey? We licensed Engine for that, and we did some of the graphics, but that was like long ago, was work for hire job, so you should probably go to the guys who published the game and ask what they are doing. For us, it was just, okay, some guy came to us and says, okay, that's $15,000, give us your code, do some work for hire. Okay, cool. Not exactly our game. One-year anniversary of the game, I think it's, yes, it's a big thing coming. Colorado V2 will be before that. We will have some design changes and design additions, features that we... Some of the features are new, some of the features we actually promised long time ago. So from my perspective, it's like that. We did lots of promises, or even if it's been vague promises, like, okay, we maybe will do that, like the cars. For cars, it's never been an advertised idea, and I always say, we will look into the cars, right? But we really feel that whatever we will do next 2-3 months, it's mostly kind of clearing car, let's say, design and technology depth to our community. Things we kind of either flat out promised like strong holds and still they are not there, or things we kind of said we will do and people started expected them. I think we should kind of clear this debt, close this kind of this part of the game development and move forward with new features coming our second year. Yes, that's exactly what I'm saying. Yes, we had cars in our original advertised screenshots. It's kind of, this kind of promise. Yes, exactly. That's kind of promise which we have to honor. I mean, yes, you can use SLI and it obviously will give you bonus for frame rate. No, for marketplace, our goal, so you can buy everything with game dollars only. There is an option to convert GC into game dollars, but that's options probably like reserved for really small number of people who just like don't want to spend any time grinding. But for me, I like that person. I am buying GC in the game. Redeeming items for game dollars, like selling hammers back to the market. No, probably not. We are adding more animations. Yes, dude, if you like, I want more functions for my private server too. I put way more than 500, I probably put like over $1 million in the game. So, and I still don't have what I want. So, but yes, we need to have more options for private servers. We need to have more control. That's, I like 100% agree with that. Retrievable arrows. I can only say that we have a list of ideas we want to implement sooner or later. That's retrievable errors is one of the things on that list. It's not on the development schedule, so I can't tell you, oh yeah, it will happen November, no. But it's on the list, it's on our wish list, what we want to do that game. Will we ever be able to sell weapons to other players for blue dollars? No. You won't be able to do that.
Because there's already comments on sweet effects on the forums as well, Lucky. So just check the general forums, it's sticky.
Wipe and global inventory. This idea been going around by community and been discussed because of that several times in a dev team. And I
sure
no, I don't think it's gonna happen. Can we have ever in the future revive the game dollars? Never say never. but I don't see it's going to happen anytime soon or even be considered anytime soon. What we are actually considering right now is lowering timeout time, revive time. So basically right now it's 1 hour. I think it's too long. I think it needs to be lowered. That's my opinion. We'll see what everybody else are saying about that. Greasy guy next to me who looks like he could be in a porn. I think that's one of those two guys, right? So. Will snipers be white? Already answered. No, not right now, not planned. To all Legion accounts and to all Pioneers accounts, guys, we are in huge debt to you. We are, you guys made our initial success with the game. You are really supported us from the day one. I think, like, we will be always in debt to you, which we probably will never be able to repay or fully, because I think you guys are kind of cornerstone of the game, and you made this game to what it is right now. You made this game successful, and just to give you all of you example of what we think, what I think Infestation is. They fold this shitty controversy around and all of the mistakes we and I personally did on the game and on the PR and marketing. That's a guy from porno, right? He looks creepy, right? I think that game is huge testament that it's become pretty successful. We have about 1.5 million players right now total, and that's our first year. I think it's remarkable, especially for being not free to play but paid game. We have really active audience in our game, and I think as being a small team in a short period of time, we did a lot and we achieved a lot. We probably been able to achieve more, and we probably wasn't like at the 100% of our game, but okay, we are trying. And once again, for all Legion and Pioneers players, thank you very much, because you guys, without you, this game wouldn't be what it become. Yeah, that's you guys are real founders of the game. Steam GC sale. Okay, Steam sales. I don't think they did Steam GC sale. I think they did Steam game sale. And Steam sales are handled by Steam. So basically, Steam comes to you and says, "Okay, guys, we have an idea. Do you agree or not?" And OP production, actually, not us, saying, "Yes, we do." So if that will happen, if they will have. Cool. Personal lockers inside PvP zone, so just camp items. How many people work in your support department? When you move offices, will you expand support team? Okay, so. We are moving offices for Arctis, and we are moving offices for development team. We are expanding our development capabilities at Arctis. I don't know if WarZ support guys will be at the same office. That's just to be honest, we are having some harsh discussions right now between us, Arctis, and OP Productions on how we move forward, so I don't know what's going to happen. But for support guys, we have about totally between Los Angeles and Chicago. We have two locations. I think about 30 people working there. So 30 people are working on both on all community tickets and all that. That's how much OP production feels they can afford right now. No, this game is not going to be on the consoles. Arctis is actually working on the game for one of the next gen consoles. Let's say that's most likely next year we'll do some announcement on that. So what I think DayZ should be in next 6 months, I think we should add more gameplay features, and by gameplay features I mean stuff to do in a game besides killing other players. Next, I think we should add more options to control private servers, and I think California map. That's our big thing for next 6 months. I don't know where Discord Resort is, but I want to go there as well. Those cheeks are cool. Will you remove zombies and add aliens? Oh, good idea. That's idea. We should rename the game. Like, Infestation is done. We should have, like, Alien Z. Alien Z. Aliens. That will be new game from us. Aliens.
How about Aliens Abduction Stories?
Yeah. Leave some probes, right?
So people have been wondering, paid name change. Any interest in ever offering that service? Just pay some GC, change your name?
I personally don't have a big stance on that, to be honest. It's like, from my standpoint, it makes sense. Lots of the people on the teams actually feel that it's really kills the game in terms of like, oh yeah, I'm the bad guy, and everybody knows that my character is like douchebag, and I changed my name, and I'm like good and like white.
Clean slate.
Yeah, clean slate. So, so that's the reason why. So it's basically like technically it's easy to do, obviously, but that's the reason why it's not happening for now.
Something else people have been wondering is changing your character model without deleting your character. So right now you
yes. That's on the plans. That should happen, and you shouldn't. We don't want you to pay any GC or GD for doing that. I think it should be like automatic. You should be able to just.
So could you change from a male to a female character then?
Yeah.
That'd be okay. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, that covers it. So that's answered, guys. Cross that one off. And yeah, there is stuff being done about players glitching on top of small market in Clearview.
Ration caliber easily leaves in Bay Area.
Basically, the plan is right now, if you're getting to an area that you're not supposed to get to, either we will add something so that you can get to it, or we will put something that kicks you off that roof. So, one way or the other, you'll either be allowed to do it, and we'll, you know, prop something up so that you can climb up on it without having to do some weird barricade hop. Or we will, you know, make it so you're not allowed to be there.
ETA on the list that I posted on forums, I think it's about that, and I said, okay, that's our kind of plan. We are still almost on the spot for what we promised. No, California GI won't be separate from Colorado. We don't have plans on wiping GI ever. No, Kuik, me and are not brothers. We probably like brothers from another mother, something like that. Be for moderators, we are actually going to add more moderators to the forums in the near future. So, California map, we plan to release it by end of the year, and after that we will still be doing some development on that. Flag guns, just like wearing, no idea what you're talking about. We don't have plans for releasing light machine guns.
Any particular reason for that? Just no LMGs? Right now they're super high trade value items, but you know they're not spawning, so they're either old spawns or dupes at this point.
I think if we will decide that, we will probably just wipe all existing LMGs, because they kind of wasn't supposed to be in the game.
Yeah, they were never intentional.
Yeah, so. And after that, we may introduce something, but there is no plans right now.
Yeah, they also need to be balanced, because
they
literally, if you are pointing right here, it will shoot over there. They're crazy right now.
Meds cooldown and all, and this, actually all cooldowns. That's something we are looking at, and once again, if our design guys and developers will decide it needs to be done, it will be done. I personally think it needs to be lowered, but there is a bunch of people around me who say no, they are fine. Planning add more armor cosmetics items. I don't think armor is a cosmetic item, but We are planning to add something new. So it's like it's been a year, with some stuff, the same stuff over and over again. So we probably gonna do something. Can you buy your own houses in California map? No, you can't buy your own houses in California map. We are actually thinking about making you, letting you get some sense of ownership, but that's actually another story. I don't want to go into that right now. List of friends and infestation when it's, as I think there is some technical problems right now, and it's been going on for a long time, so I really can tell you when it's gonna happen. PvE servers. Okay, so no snipers is one thing. PvE is another. We guys are thinking about how to make PvE experience more fun. So that's what all I can say right now. Season changes, probably not. Season changes, probably not. It's too much work.
Oh, said it's not bannable right now. If we don't want you up there, we'll put something up there so that you can't get up there, or we'll make an easier way to get up there.
Okay, guys. Unfortunately, it's been an hour and a half, and I have a guy waiting for me for a meeting, so I have to jump. And hopefully we'll do it next week.
Next week, yeah.
Yeah.
End of the week again.
Yeah, let's do it weekly.
Okay. All right, guys. So there you go. There you have it. So if you didn't get your question answered this week, you guys, just make sure that you know you have it ready for next week.
Yeah.
You can put it in the other thread. And let's go run around in game real quick. We'll actually go and play some.